In this project, we are going to explore the design rule system and apply design rules for physical and spacing dimensions. First, you need to place the unplaced board somewhere. Then go to Setup, Constraints and Physical. There you need to select the All Layers worksheet under the Physical Constraint folder. In the default row, change all the values of minimum line width, minimum neck width and the minimum VWire values to 6. As shown in the form, you can change all the values to 6. After that, select the default cell. Go to Objects. We need to create physical CSET. There you can rename the physical CSET as 8mm line. Then click OK. Enter the name as 8mm line. The 8mm line is created here. In this, you need to change all the values in the row to 8. We are changing the minimum value to 8, the neck value to 8. VB via stagger value to 8. Your form should look like this. Once you complete this, in the next part, we are going to identify the special physical nets. To do so, select all layers, then select the unplaced cell, click it. So, you need to scroll down to VCLKA and VCLKC nets, which are visible here. VCLKA and VCLKC. You need to press shift and select both at a time. You need to right click on the mouse, then select create knit class. In this, give the knit class name as SYNC. Then select OK. After this, we are going to assign the net class. To do so, select the referenced physical set. In the sync row, SYN0, the reference physical set. From there, you need to change the value from default to 8mm line. We pull down the default value to 8mm line width. After you do so, we need to close the file. We need to save this up. You can save this as constraints board. After this, we are going to set the spacing rules. In this section, we are going to define spacing routing rules for special nets. To do so, open the file, then select the setup, constraints and spacing. From there, go to line worksheet. In that, you find a default row section. Here, you need to change all the values to 6. Line to line value, line to cell value, line to bond symbol value, all these values to 6. After this, select objects, create spacing CSET. In that form, you need to enter the name as 8mm space, as this is spacing set. Okay, then 8mm space is created. 8mm space is created here. In this, you need to make sure that all the values are 8. Change all the values to 8. After that, we are going to assign the net class. And we are going to change the values to 8. After that, we are going to close it. In the next lab, we are going to set class to class rules. Now we are going to define a new spacing rule. To do so, we need to select the line worksheet from the All Layers workbook. There you need to click on the default. Then select the constraints, objects, membership. There in the spacing set, you need to create it as a 15. Spacing. You need to change all the values to 15. Once you finish giving all these values, you can also do it in the other way. Once you finish giving these values, we can save the file. After this, in the next lab, we are going to work with the properties. We are going to attach, display and delete properties in a design. To do so, we need to open the constraints board, choose edit properties. Before that, we need to create net class for the 15mm as well. So we are going to assign a new net class here from the line worksheet. Open the constraint cell. In the create net class form, enter BD nets for the name. Select the BD, then objects, membership, net class. Select it as 15mm space. Objects, we need to create a membership. So we need to go to group members. Here we need to scroll down to find out VD0 and VD7 values. From VD0 to VD7, you just need to click the right shift, enter all the values and assign it. Click OK. Once you assign the net class membership values, we need to assign the class to class rule. To do so, select the line worksheet. And select the VDNet cell. Then go to create class to class as shown in class to class. Here scroll down to find the values of VDNets. You will find VDNets. Assign as shown here. After this, we need to select the reference space set in the VDNet and change the values from 8mm to 15mm space. Once you give these values, you can close the file and save the board. In the next lab, we are going to work with the properties. Here we are going to attach, display and delete properties in a design. To do so, we need to go to edit properties from the top menu. Edit properties. In the right hand side, you can find by name section in the find filter. In the find by name, scroll down to set the field as component or pin. In the entry field, you can enter it as J1. In the edit property form, then click more. Also, you can enter the tab key. Once you enter the tab key, you can find the edit property window here. In this edit property, you need to scroll down to find hard location and fixed properties. Hard location and fixed properties. These two properties appear to the right. Then apply. You can find these two locations here. These properties are shown here. This displays the properties. In the next section, we are going to attach fixed properties to the symbols using icons. Select the fix icon. Then in the find filter, you need to select all off and click only symbols. Click on the two B and C connectors as shown. This adds a fixed property to these three objects. In the next session, we are going to add room property to the components. To do so, go to Edit Properties. In the Find by Name, scroll the list of the components. Select Node. There you need to scroll down for D1, D2, D3, D4 values. Component. In an order, D1, D2, D3, and D4. Click apply. Four components are now selected for editing. In the blank value field next to the room property, here you need to select room from the available properties. In the blank value, you need to enter it as LEV. LED apply. Then in the show properties you can find all the rooms for LEDs. Click OK. Next we are attaching properties to nets. To do so, from the find by name filter, we need to scroll down to the description box to set as net. In the blank field, VCC. Then hit Tab key. Editor property form appears. Editor property form appears. From that, scroll down to min line width. The property appears now on the right. We need to scroll it from min line width. We need to set them in line with value to 15. After that, we are going to repeat the same thing for ground. To do so, enter GND instead of VCC and go to min line width. change it as 15 mil. Then click apply. Okay. Done. In the next session, we are going to show existing properties on the elements in the design. To do so, open the edit properties. Then in the blank field under the net and the fine filter, under the net, under the blank field, just type the star symbol and hit tab key. You can find all the properties are displayed in the show properties tab. After this, you can save the file. You can just close the show properties and at the editor property form and save the file. We are going to name it with a different name because these are the net properties. We are going to save this file as net props. Next, we are going to choose the display property from the top. Then we are going to scroll for the room property. Click the show value button. Here you can see all the values are shown here. This displays the functions and the components within the room. Then you can close the window. Now we are going to delete the properties. Choose edit properties under the component of bin. Just type in as J1. When you hit the tab key, you can find the show properties window appears and it says J1 is the property which is fixed. So just click on the hard selection, hard location, click apply and okay. The property is deleted. You can just save it as constrain board file.